Now, as you see, I'm dressed in a very relaxed attire, and that is because it's Family Month at Kingsway Ministries International. Yes, and we're on the beach this weekend celebrating with our young people and our elders, and it's part of the Family Month celebrations. So you can join us, bring your family, and come on through. We have lots of activities. This is just one of the things that we do this month. We have the culmination of our Family Month Love Feast, which happens on the final Sunday of this month. So you can look forward to that. You can come and join us. You'll hear more about that in the upcoming program. So we thank you for joining us on Kingsway today, and we pray that you will be like us. Have been an agent of love in your home, and that's the theme for this month of family. Being an agent of love in your home, and it's taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. So you can stay tuned for the rest of what we have in store for you today, and welcome to Family Month. This is King.
Thank you, what shall Lord. We say?
What shall I say unto the Lord? All I have to say is thank
what
you,
shall
Lord.
We say?
What shall I say?
Can say no.
When Jesus lifts you up, nobody can bring you down.
When Jesus
Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When 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 Jesus lifts you up, nobody can pull you down.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus lifts you up, nobody can pull you down.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When Papa say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When my Papa say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
When your Papa say yes, nobody can say no.
When Jesus say yes, nobody can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
Nobody
can say no.
The final say.
Jehovah has the final say.
Who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
Who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
Who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
Jehovah, turn my life around.
Jehovah, turn my life around. He makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say. Jehovah, turn my life around. Jehovah, turn my life around.
Oh,
he makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say.
I ask, who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
The final say.
Jehovah has the final say.
Who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
Who has the final say?
Jehovah has the final say.
Jehovah,
turn my life around. Jehovah, turn my life around.
Oh, he
makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say. Jehovah, turn my life around.
Jehovah, turn my life around.
He makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say.
Jehovah, turn my life around.
Jehovah, turn my life around. He makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say.
God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
Oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, oh my God, you are good.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God, you are good. Oh my God. Oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God,
you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good.
Shineke,
shineke, inema. Shineke, shineke,
shineke,
shineke, shineke, inema. Shineke, 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 inema. Shineke, shineke,
shineke,
shineke, shineke, inema. Shineke, shineke,
inema,
inema, inema, inema. Shineke, inema, 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 inema. Shineke, inema, 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 inema. Shineke, inema, 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 inema.
Inema,
inema, inema, inema.
Shineke, inema,
inema, inema, inema.
Oh my God,
oh my God,
oh my God, you are good.
Oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God,
oh my God,
oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God,
oh my God,
oh my God, oh my God, you are good. Oh my God, oh my God,
you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God,
you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God,
you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good. You are good, you are good, you are good. Oh my God, you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good.
Oh my God, you are good.
You are good, you are good, you are good.
Oh my God, you are good.
Hallelujah. We serve a good God. We Amen. Serve a good God.
Amen.
We said, oh my God, oh my God,
Hallelujah.
He is my God. We gotta make it personal. He is my God,
Amen.
My God.
Hallelujah.
He is my God. I don't know about you this morning, but He is my God.
Hallelujah.
And I know that He has been good, and I know that He's gonna continue to be good. Hallelujah. 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 We bless you, God. We bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. We truly serve a good God, a God that never fails. We join with the angels this morning and we just cry, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy are you, Lord. Sound of heaven, it's a sound of living waters, it's a sound of worship coming from your throne. There are cries of adoration has been from every nation. Lift their voice to make His glory known. Singing,
holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
My God, you are holy.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
The elders and angels bow.
The elders and angels bow. The redeemed. Living waters, it's a sound of worship. Come
experience the glow.
The Victory Christian Academy Preschool and Daycare is a school of excellence catering for babies and children from 3 months to 5 years. We are open from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, and babysitting service is available on request. For information and registration, visit the church office in St. Cecil or contact us on 639-5464.
Friend, thank you for staying tuned. You are still on Kingsway, and we're very glad that you are still with us. You are on the segment, What's Happening? Let me tell you, things that are still happening where we are concerned, and I'm not talking generally. With the kingdom people, things are still happening with us in Tobago. The way for us to be able to spread it around is for you to bring what is happening around you to us, and we're going to broadcast it for you. We're doing it now free of charge, all right? Don't wait till the time that we begin to ask you to pay before you start coming, right? So come with what is happening in your church, in your family, in your community, your village council, the things that you are doing or you're about to do, things that are passed already, you could bring them and we will broadcast them for you. The major event that is at hand now is Glow Fest, right? It's going to be a tremendous time. You know, it's going to be a tremendous time. You need to listen to the ad as we give it to you. That chap called Travis Green is coming this year, all right? It's tremendous where worship is concerned, and you need to have that live experience with him. I have watched him on YouTube, you know, several of his music on YouTube. He is tremendous. So I'm encouraging you to buy your ticket for Glow. It's going. I think it's on the 9th of October. 8th of October, I'm corrected, 8th of October. You know why? I won't tell you why I'm missing the date. Don't worry, I won't tell you. But it's going to be a great event at Shopak Cultural Complex. That's where the fellowship is on that day. And all our local guest artists are going to be there. My son and the Lord, Joel Murray, Positive, going to be there, and the rest of them, you know. So you can't miss that time of worship, time of fellowship again. Tremendous time for the people of God rallying together. So on the 8th of October, Glow Fest, don't miss it at all. And I also want to let you know that we are taking children in our school, Victory Christian Academy, a safe environment, a spirit-filled environment, you know, with the anointed teachers taking care of your children. The daycare is there. The preschool is there. We are still receiving your children. We receive them from age, about age 3 months, when the mother is going back. As soon as the mother is ready to go back to work, we take them from you. And you know, take care of them, build them, be part of their growth spiritually, physically, medically, and all. You know, we are part of it, and grow them to that time that they go in into big school, the primary school. And then also something is in place now. We're preparing for our primary school. If you want to know, you can call us at 639-5464. So we are taking children also from standard 3 to 5. Standard 3 to 5. Evening classes for them. So you can call us and find out more about them, how you can get your children enlisted at Victory Christian Academy. We have spaces for your preschoolers, we have spaces for daycare schoolers, and then also the standard 3 children up to standard, from standard 3 up to standard 5. So call us and we'll let you know more. about that by the grace of the Almighty God. So that's all I have for you on what's happening this week. I want you to stay tuned with us. We are still on. Don't forget, you can come and see us and we will broadcast your event on this segment. Stay tuned, my friend.
Experience the glow.
There has been 25. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face against the Ammonites and prophesy against them. Not prophesy to them. Prophesy against them because they are not of God. Say to the Ammonites, hear the word of the Lord God. Thus says the Lord God, because you said, aha. You may not know what that means. If you are a Yoruba man, that will hit you. You will know. Because you said, aha, against my sanctuary when it was profaned, and against the land of Israel when it was desolate, and against the house of Judah when they went into captivity. Indeed, therefore, I will deliver you as a possession to the men of the east, and they shall set their encampment against you and make their dwellings among you. They shall eat your fruit, and they shall drink your drink, your milk. What is God doing there? The people that watch, that watch the people of God, the covenant people of God, when they were in their problem, and say, good for you. That's what that aha means. Yes, yeah, good for them. Yeah, they're going down. They are all dying now. The spirit of death. He said, that's why I ask you to change your language. You can't be speaking like the heathen. All right? They come and whisper it in your ears. The spirit of death is over them. And then you carry it also. And you start missing in church. You don't want the spirit of death to rest upon you. And if the spirit of death is going to rest upon you, will find you anywhere. They are not here this morning. Don't worry. It's not you I'm talking about. But looking at what God said, that's the principle. That's the principle that God has established. You know, those who ridicule his people when they are in their time of tribulation and time of trouble, he turns around, and after he delivers his people, he turns around and lick them up. He said calamity will fall upon them. He will allow calamity to fall upon them. He will allow them to be, you know, to be repossessed. Like, you know, like the furniture that you bought from, that people bought from courts and they didn't pay for, or like car, they repossess. So it's going to allow the heathen or a stronger nation or even a weaker nation to come and take care of them so that what they're producing, they will not be enjoying. Said their fruits and everything, they will take over. You know, I just read that, but go further. There are other nations that he spoke to. If you read the whole of Ezekiel 25, that all those people that ridicule his people or that made it harder for his people when they were going through, they are going through. Huh? He dealt with every one of them. Said, speak, prophesy against them. This is what will happen. And you know when God says, this is what will happen? It will happen. Jump high, jump low, it will happen. That's our situation. All right? That's our situation. And that's why I'm warning you to change your language. Don't flow with the enemy. Let's come out. Today is better. Thank God. Today is better. Last week, my words were just bouncing back at me. As you sat down there, the words that I was speaking to you were just bouncing back. Yeah, today is good. Because God is at work. You're responding to God's work. I will know it because he placed me. All right? He placed me here to do what is causing me to do. I'm not moving by my hand. That's why I'm not important. I'm not the one important. It's God who is important. That's why I don't run after being important. If it's to run after being important. Four Sundays in a month, you will see me two Sundays or one Sunday. I'll be all over the place as an apostle. Yeah, my own type of apostolic movement is different. All right? It's not to go and proclaim myself. Leave that alone. All right? Don't place your focus on me. All right? But it's God and you direct. It's God and you direct. All right? So, don't follow the heathen. Don't let the heathen detect. Don't let situations that surround you detect what happened in your life and how you see God. I have believed him. I have trusted him. And I ain't see it. If you ain't see it, sit down. Honestly, sit down in the hand of God. Sit down. What did I say? Sit down. Here, where? In the hand of God. If you ain't see it, you've done your part. Leave it right there. You will not languish. There's a woman who comes to breakthrough hour. When she was going through, every Wednesday when we finish, me and her in that room, she must see me after. But the word of the Lord was coming for her and coming to her that you will not languish. You will not be thrown on the street. That's what I was just hearing. I didn't know what was coming. That's what I was just hearing for this woman. And I kept telling her that don't worry. What I'm hearing is this. What I'm hearing is this. Do you know the tragedy came? We couldn't push back the tragedy. God saw it that we wouldn't have been able to push back that tragedy. It happened. The whole of Tobago heard about it. I'm not going to tell you what happened so that you know many things have happened. Tragedy in Tobago already. I'm passing. And this was years now. About 2-3 years ago now. It happened. But what happened to this woman? Well taken care of. Well taken care of. Because that's what God was saying. God knew what was going to happen, that this one cannot be prevented. Listen, people. Listen to this. I don't know. I want to preach that message. Lord, help me. I spent time. I couldn't sleep. I prepared that message. I want to preach it. But hear this. Hear this. Love come. It's you I could use for this example. Don't be tired now. You know what is happening between me and her today? Before I tell you what I want to tell you. She has told me what kind of meal she wants, and I cooking it after church. The meat is already somewhere there. I'm going to do special seasoning direct in the pot. Is Michelle teach me that? Yeah, listen. When you are connected to somebody, listen, when you are connected, we have covenant relationship. But there, in that covenant relationship, there are still certain things that you cannot control. You will pray. You will pray. You will fast. You will fast. You will fast. You will pray. You will seek the heart of God, the face of God. Still, it will still go and happen. Because there are some part of her that I cannot control. There's some part of me that she can't control. Because even though it's molding us, 1 + 1 = 1, even though that is a covenant relationship, everybody still have to do their part. So you will be praying. You'll be groaning before God. I have done all. I believe God. God. You still have to do with her. So while you're doing that, I'm just using it as a sum. While you're doing that, because it must happen, God will be preparing you. God will be putting things in place to succor you when it happens. Because it's not if, again, because God saw it. And it's going to happen because the individual probably, I don't know all the examples, I built a shield around themselves. All right? Or that it's better for them. Let me use that one is better to hear. It's better for them that it happened. But physically speaking, it's not really, you won't really enjoy it when it happened. But God will begin to put things in place to take care of you. You know, to take care of you. Why will he do that? Because you are in his hand. Because you trust him. So when it happens, you not going to break down forever. You're going to summon courage and know that, yes, I have trusted God. And this still going and happen. It happened because even God couldn't stop it. You understand me this morning? You understand me? That's what happens when you have relationship with human being and with God. Are you getting me this morning? That's it. Please. Put your hands together for us. You will know. It's the month of family, all right? I told her this morning that nobody could have made her look the way she's looking now apart from me. It's me God is using. I told her certain things that I saw with her before. I could boast like that now. That certain things that I saw in her bodily, I ain't God. Bodily, I'm talking about. He look pretty. Doesn't she look pretty? Or prettier? How many people knew her 10 years ago? Oh, Lord. She was just acceptable to me alone. 10 years ago, she was just acceptable to me alone. But now, oh, Lord! I ask her, what should be the bidding now? How much? She hasn't answered that question up till now. Eh? Because she's just getting better and better and better and better. Because God is using me. Amen. When she has the mic, she will have the opportunity to say her own. But now, I'm holding the mic. Open your Bible with me. 1 Corinthians 13. I have about 10 minutes to do what I had to do. Amen? Amen? Amen. God is at work. Amen. Amen. Oh, Pastor Denon is missing all this. Oh, shucks. She's one woman in this house that understands me. Lord of glory. Amen. 1 Corinthians 13, 1 to 13. All right. We read it last week. I'm not going to go into it. We are talking about being an agent of love in our family. And that word love is qualified by the scriptures from 1 to the end. That love that we are talking about. But quickly, let's look at who an agent is, because that's what God wants us to be. Who is an agent? An agent is a person or business authorized to what? Act on another's behalf. Act on another's behalf. Or a person or thing that acts or has the power to act. The active word there is what? Act. Has been selected, has been positioned to act. All right? So I went straight. There's no time to go and be breaking down too much. I went to look at the word act also. It means to do something. To exert energy or force. Or be employed or operative. That's the word act. And also to operate or function in a particular way. Perform specific duties or function. Or to produce an effect or perform a function. So that's what God is calling us into, people of God, in our homes. So what it means is that God doesn't want us to be passive. You see that relationship? God doesn't want you to be passive. You and Pastor Philip together, you know, God doesn't want it to just be Pastor Philip alone doing stuff. It's both of you. You have a part. And he wants you to be one in the relationship doing your part. In the family life, God doesn't want it to be Minister Mama alone or Minister Papa alone. God wants you as a child in the relationship to be doing your part, to be active, to be doing something, to be performing some function, to be doing specific things that are ordered by God for children of the family to do. God wants you to represent the family as a child in the family, Ezekiel, in the family of Mr. and Mrs. Laurel. Huh? He wants you to be a part in that. You have a function. You are an agent. So, and taking it beyond that, we are agents of God in our families. I told you last week that you didn't choose your family. You couldn't. You couldn't choose your biological family. None of us could do that. So we were placed in our families. So we are placed in our family to be an agent of God. An agent of God. First of his love. To showcase his love. You see, all those things that are written for us as husband and as wife and as children. You know, children, obey your parents in the Lord. It's about you. Expressing love as you obey your parents, you are expressing love. You are an agent of love because you are obeying God. You are representing God. You are representing who God is. It's God who established it. Lord, bring down the rain. Bring down the rain. God! Don't take me on. God! Because I just want you to be able to get this so that rain keeps us here a little longer. You can't go and get yourself wet. You want to catch the cold or what? So you have to stay and get it. You know, I don't want you to catch Zika. Zika is in the rain. So you can't go and catch that. Right. So God wants you primarily to begin to do something that showcases his love. To begin to operate, to begin to function. And it would take energy from you. Listen, it would take an energy from you. It will cost you something to manifest as the agent of God. You have to exert something. It will cost you something. Whether you are the child in the family, or you are the father, or you are the mother, that which God is requiring you will cost you something. Must cost you something. You are an agent. Agent pay prices before they now get paid. They must pay prices. If they are driving, they have to buy gas into the car that they are driving, into the truck that they are using as an agent. If it's just to be in an office, insurance agent, there's something that they have to pay. There's an energy. There's something from you that has to go into the system that God has located you. Did we get that? That's an agent. That's who God wants you to be. God wants you to pick up your role in your family. Don't neglect your role in the family. Whether in the biological family or in the family of God, God wants you to be one of the agents there. Manifesting the love of God. So to manifest the love of God would take something from you. Listen to me, love is sacrificial. Love is not love when it has nothing to give. When it doesn't give anything. It is not love. So let's begin to look at love. The word love, you know, according to the scripture. Love is from the original language of the New Testament, which is Greek, from the word agape, A-G-A-P-E. And this is what it does. It describes God's attitude towards us. So you get to know what God is asking you to go and use, what God is asking you to go and peddle, what God is asking you to go and sell as an agent. What God is asking you to go and manifest. So it first describes God's attitude towards his son, Jesus. John 17, 26. You're going to read all those things by yourself. All right? And also towards human race generally. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Romans 5, 8, that, you know, while we were still the enemies of God, God went and died for us. He went. So, he had no consideration for anything that we were. God did not consider anything that we were at that time. So, that's the nature of the love that he's asking us to go and demonstrate. So go and manifest. And then number three, the third part of it, the attitude of that God's love. So these three things are the attitude, where you could see the attitude of God's love. Is the kind of love that he manifests to his son, the kind of love that he manifests in human race generally. We gone through. We went away from him. We ran away. God going this way, we turned this way. And he turned back to pick us and turned back to himself. And it cost him a lot. And also, attitude towards those who believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. What is God's attitude towards after we are saved? Did he just leave us there? No. His love is peak for us, at the peak for us. He considers us in every way, in every way, in every way, in every move that God make. God considers us. So number two, that kind of love conveys God's will to his children concerning their attitude one toward another. One toward another. and toward all men. Look at what 1 Thessalonians chapter 3 says from verse 12. It said, and may the Lord. No, that's not that. I think that's it. Yeah, that's the scripture there. Yeah, I got it. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love to one another and to all. To one another. Huh? First to one another in the family of God and to all. Just as we do to you. So that he may establish your hearts blameless in what? Holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ with all his saints. Saying, you know, the kind of manifestation that he wants from you to another child of God is one of the characteristics of holiness. I got you. All right. We think we are holy just when we do not commit sin, what we call sin. We think that's the only thing that makes us holy. We think we are holy when we don't use makeup and we don't use jewelry. Why, pastor, a man putting on necklace? It's the month of family. I rejoice in that celebrating. I asked my wife this morning, where's my gold chain? You see, women, get some secret about your home. We are in the month of family. I could say this. Get a secret, one secret. Everything that is missing in the house, you know where it goes. Everything that cannot be found in the house, you know where it is. That's law number one in family life. All right? Take note of that. My shoe that I wore to church last Sunday, where is it located? Where? I thought she wore the shoe to church. All right, let's come back to what we are talking about. One to another. One to another, the love, is one of the characteristics of holiness. It's not about our appearance. You are not holy until you are expressing love of God correctly to your sister here or towards me. If you are wrong in your behavior towards me, you are not holy. You are not manifesting holiness. If the love of God is not first obeyed, you are not holy. Stop all the don't wear wig. Don't wear. Some people say if you wear a wig, you ain't going to heaven. Oh, Lord of glory. You can run those who sell wig out of. No, it's not that. It said so that he may establish your heart. Are you looking at that scripture? Please come with me. I know it's just 2 minutes left. God help me. All right? On a love feast day, I will finish it. All right? But take this. You've gotten two characteristics. God's attitude, that love, agape that we're talking about, describing God's attitude. It is expressed, it is demonstrated in his attitude towards his son, towards human race generally, towards those who believe. And also, what he will want or want to see between those who are saved to one another and those who are saved to those who are not saved. Yeah. That's why he would say to you, love your neighbor according to how you love yourself. Yeah. That's why he would say that. Who is your neighbor? Anybody that you have opportunity to reach out to. So you're not going to say you ain't reaching out.
All right, guys. Well, unfortunately, that brings us to the end of Kingsway today. But we thank you for joining us, and we thank you and your family for being a part of the family of God. And we indeed release a blessing upon you and your family in this time, in this month, in this season. And we encourage you to continue being an agent of love in your own home and in your family. But before we send you off, we pray a blessing upon you, upon your family, and upon your life. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our viewers here. We thank you for all those that are part of the family of God. We pray about a tremendous blessing upon their lives today and every day, even as they go into the rest of the week. We pray, God, that the people of God will help them to be agents of love within their own homes, within their churches, within wherever they might be, God, that they will represent the love of Christ. Father, Lord, we pray that you would order their steps, and even those that we are receiving to come to Christ this month, our family, our unsaved friends, that they will experience and encounter you in the mighty name of Jesus. So, we give you thanks, we give you praise in everything, in Jesus' name. So, family and friends, we thank you again for joining us for Kingsway. Remember that you can contact us at Kingsway Ministries at 639-5464, or you can find us on Facebook. You can join us for services on Sunday mornings at 9:45 family worship, Wednesdays at 12:50, that's our breakthrough hour, and on Wednesday evenings at 6:30 p.m. that's our time of prayer and Bible study. And those of you, our families, that live in the western side or in the Kandy area, you can join us at Kingsway Community Church, that's behind the Mugaro Uno, on Sunday mornings at 8:30 a.m. and for Bible study on Thursday at 6:30 p.m. So again, we thank you for joining us for Kingsway. Remember, it's family month, so take some time and spend with your family and richly bless them, and reach out to those that you have not yet reached out to or have not touched for a very long time. So again, thank you, and this has been Kingsway.
Experience the glow.
It's a sound of living waters. It's a sound of worship coming from your throne. There are cries of adoration that's been from every nation. Lift their voice to make his glory.